Hello everyone, welcome to TubeView channel, I'm Henry. Last time, I have made a water pump using a gum plastic bottle. It can work, but the efficiency of the pump is not promising. It can prove the concept, but not good for real usage, unless you make it very precisely. Today, I will tell you how to make a good water pump using 3D printed volume casing, specially designed impeller and a mini DC 130 motor. I will do comprehensive experiments and tell you what happened. Stick around. Let's start. The water pump has a lot of different types depending on the mechanisms to induce the water and exit the water. Mostly used are a rotary vane pump and a centrifugal pump, especially in the homemade water pump. If the pump directly into the water, it will be more efficient than outside of the water, since it will directly push the water out of the chamber. This kind of pump also called submersible pump and widely used in many places. It is very important to see the motor out of water since the pump always in water circumstance. The shape of the impeller and the volute casing will influence the efficiency very much. At first, I download a water pump motor from Thingiverse. It is very good in design, since the impeller shape is quite fit in optimized condition. When I print out, I have found some places need to modify for a good submerging water pump. The motor chamber is too thin. The chamber is not completely closed. The impeller chamber is not well fixed. I made some modifications, so the final model is like this. For the impeller, I also made some modifications based on the optimized impeller shape. Shape 1. I use 3 blades, which the blade shape is fit the optimized shape. The upper part bend a little like a fan to make more suction power according to my understanding. Sample 2. 4 blades with the bent shape as sample 1. Sample 3, the download version which the blade is perpendicular to the volute casing. Sample 4, a simple straight blade which most of the homemade water pump use this shape, so-called radical blades. Sample 5, shift the straight blade to fit the concept of optimized condition. Sample 6, similar to the optimized shape with a little modification according to my understanding. Sample 7, 6 blades instead of 4 as sample 6. For motor, I use mini DC 130 series. Number 1, the Marbridge FA130RA motor, work at 1.5V to 3.0V. Number 2, power dash specially tuned for more power than normal Marbridge 130 motor, also worked at 1.5V to 3.0V. Number 3, 130 series, mini motor, but can work from 1.5V to 12V. For the power supply, I choose 1.5V, 3.0V, 5.0V and 9V, which you can use 1 AA battery, 2 AA batteries, USB power directly and 9V battery, respectively. Let's find out which one is the best according to the experimental results. First, I check the AA battery condition. I use a little bit old AA battery for test. For Marbridge motor, the voltage at lower load decreased to about 83%. The mini motor is in a similar condition, which decreased to about 87%. The power dash motor decreased the voltage very much and increased the decrease rate with the increased voltage. This means the power dash motor needs more power to work compared to the Marbridge motor and the mini motor. The working current increased with the increase in voltage. For 3V homemade DC power supply, which has a simple regulator circuit LM2593 DC-DC converter inside, the output voltages keep constant, even power dash just decrease a little to 91% to 0.7 volt. It means the DC regulator works very well in low load or no load condition. Small power condition, about 5 volt in fact. for USB power supply directly, connect to a USB output port. Mavovich motor and mini motor keep constant, but power dash cannot work in this USB power supply. 5 volt maxim. This means the power of the Mavovich and the mini motor are less than 5 volt, but the power of power dash increased significantly in large supply voltage. Fortunately, it just stops working, not to break the USB power station and the motor itself. This means power dash will decrease the working resistance and increase the working current, increase the load torque. When the value of the power over the output power of the USB power supply, it cannot work. You need a more powerful power supply to support this motor. Just like a homemade power station, I simply wired together. It can support up to 65 volt power, I think. The regulator circuit can support up to 75 volt, but my notebook's power supply can only support to 65 volt. It can support the power very stable in this case. We can see O motor can work even in as low as 0.5 voltage. Let's start check which impeller is the best one. In order to get more correct results in constant input power supply voltage, I will use the DC regulator power station for my study, and measure the hydraulic head height to define the impeller quality. Thanks, the Mavovich and the mini motor will overflow the maximum height of my homemade water pressure gauge, 1 meter height. I used the power dash motor, 3 volt power, as a test sample. Here we can see the volute number 1 and number 2 gives more height. This means the shape of the impellers gives smaller pressure against the volute chamber or lossless hydraulic head. The number 6 and 7 give large height. This means the shape of the impellers have high potential to pump out the water, but it will also lose hydraulic head. Others are in the middle area. Let's check another parameter, the pump speed, flow rate. I use empty plastic bottle for the test. The volume is 1530 mm when fully filled. When I use the simple DC-DC regulator, which powered by a USB power station, 5 volt output in maximum. For Mavovich motor, the working voltage decreased to about 1.67 volt. The working current should be 2.99 ampere on average. It took 42.92 seconds to fill the empty bottle. The flow rate is 2.14 liter per minute. The volute number 2 works in the best performance condition. For a mini motor, working voltage keeps constant almost. It took 41.52 seconds to fill the empty bottle. The flow rate is 2.21 liter per minute. The volute number 2 again keep the first position. Volute number 7 works also not bad. For super dash motor, the working volute decreased dramatically. It is only 0.7 volt, almost decreased by 86%. The working current becomes very large, 2.13 ampere. It took 44.89 seconds to fill the empty bottle. It means you need a more powerful power supply or add some resistance to reduced current. It is not suitable to use DC power supply for this tuned motor, in fact. I have noticed that there is a cylinder in the valve center to fix the motor shaft. It may hinder the water flow, hence decrease the efficiency of the water pump. I changed the construction to move the cylinder under the valve bottom surface. Let's see what will happen. For Mavovich motor and super dash, since they already work in an overload condition, the working voltage keeps the same as the no support layer condition. And since this construction adds a little more weight, the flow rate even becomes smaller. For the mini motor, it helps a little bit, but not so much. Since all of them are MIDI type, these effects will not give much help. For USB power supplied condition, the named output voltage is 5.0, but the maximum power is 5 volt. It is not get better for Mavovich 130 motor, since 3.0 volt DC regulator use the same power station. For the power dash motor, this USB power will not work out. For mini motor, the working voltage keeps almost constant. The average time is 31.57 seconds, which the flow rate is 2.91 liter per minute. Larger than 3-point volt condition, 2.21 liter per minute. This means mini motor use smaller power but work at a great output in USB power supply station. When using a 9 volt power supply, PP3 type or motor 6422 in my case, at first it works fine but soon it cannot work at all. This is not as I expected at first think, but after I researched the information through the internet, I have figured out that 9-volt battery is not as powerful as we usually think. Its capacity is usually smaller than a single AA battery, usually only have several hundred milliwatt, such as 500 milliwatt, almost one-fourth of a normal AA battery, 2000 milliwatt. It is used for high voltage but low current condition such as a multimeter. But for the motor, it works usually at a high current condition. The current means torque for the motor. In fact, the voltage means speed for motor. When I change to my homemade power supply station, it works very well. The voltage keeps constant, 8.92 volt. It took 23.91 seconds to fill the empty motor. The flow rate is 3.84 liter per minute. It is quite powerful for 130 series DC motor. I also checked 1.5 times, 2 times larger volume size condition. The working voltage keeps constant, but the times increased, the flow rate decreased. This means in a larger size, the mini motor cannot give sufficient power to driving the impeller. Now, we start to check the rear AA battery power supply. When using one AA battery, Marmage 130 motor takes 60.26 seconds to fill the empty motor. After finish, the no load voltage decreases a little. For power-130, the working voltage decreases quite a lot as usual. After finish, the no load voltage decreases quite a lot. For mini motor 130, same as Marmage's 130 motor, but use more time to fill the empty motor. For 2 AA battery, Marmage 130 motor takes 40.26 seconds to fill the empty motor. After finish, the no load voltage decreases later. For the power-130 motors, the working voltage decreases very much, and after the finish, the no load voltage also decreases quite a lot, even only use it for 30 seconds. It takes 30.39 seconds to fill the empty motor. For mini motor 130, it takes just half of the time as one AA battery condition. This means the mini motor is an economical choice for a long time working. Now we have done enough experiments. I can tell you some results based on these experimental results. For impeller, the number 2 volute and the number 7 are the best one. Number 2 uses less power to do the same work, and usually takes less time to fill the empty motor. Number 7 has the high potential to do a similar work, also it takes a good time to do the work. The support layer will not give help in this mini motor type. For motor, when you want to use at a small voltage, large current, the power dash is the best choice. For only use normal condition, the Marmage motor is very good. It can work between 1.5 to 3.0 in the specification manual. In fact, it can work in 0.5 to 5 volt range without any problem. For economical consideration or high power, high voltage, the mini motor is your choice. It works very stable in small voltage range. It gives high power in the high voltage range. For power supply, if you only use a short time, the AA battery is good. But for long time use, you should consider the rear capacity of the USB power supply. It works very good for the mini motor but not work for super dash motor. The 9-volt power supply is not giving high power. It is good for low current, high voltage condition, but for the high current condition, it is not a good choice. subscribe button. Also, leave your comments so we can know each other. I'm looking forward to seeing you soon again. Hope you will have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, click on the small bell so you will not miss the update. TVU China is waiting for you.